We have a presentation by Ryan Rhoten. Is Ryan here this evening?
I am.
Oh, Ryan, I apologize, I didn't meet you in the hallway. Ryan is interested in making a presentation on what it would take for the citizens of White River Township to look at incorporation as a town from the city's point of view, correct?
Yeah, correct. Not so much a presentation as it is to ask for this council approval.
The only comment I've got is based on the fact that we have a study committee going on right now, and until that study committee is complete, it's, I don't think it's appropriate for us to approve or disapprove something like that. We started the ball rolling back in December, and if it goes through, then your question doesn't need to be answered. If it doesn't go through, don't answer the question at that point.
I agree. Yeah, I agree with you. We have some time, but one of the reasons why I wanted to come to this council today is so that we could go ahead and begin as citizens to start looking at incorporation as a potential option for the White River Township area, specifically the center of Rhoten. If you allow me for a minute before I kind of start here, I'd like to thank the mayor for his office for allowing me and to be on the agenda this evening. And if you could please extend your thanks to Elaine for putting up all of my annoying questions that I had to get here. But as the agenda says, my name is Ryan Rhoten. I'm a citizen of White River Township. I'm here tonight representing a growing number of citizens in the township who would like to begin to study the possibility of incorporating into the town of Center Grove, Indiana. Over the last few months, we've had the opportunity to study the Indiana Code for Incorporation, which is 36-5-1. And during the course of our evaluation of the code, there's a particular section, and specifically a paragraph, that we would like to come forth. That's what I'm here for tonight, is to talk to you about that particular paragraph. This code, if you read it, it spells out the process, the steps, as well as, most importantly, the approvals that must be attained in order for any area in the state of Indiana to become a town or a city. And if I could, I'd like to read the specific paragraph that's in question. The paragraph number, taking notes, is 36-5-1-7, specifically point for paragraph B. It states, the county executive must obtain the consent by ordinance of the legislative body of a second or third class city before incorporating a town of any part of the proposed city is within 3 miles of the corporate boundaries of that city. So obviously White River Township butts up to the city of Greenwood. So one of the reasons, if you took this code and you laid it out as a flowchart, you would find that this particular step happens at the very end of the process. Rather than take a lot of time, money, and effort and get together citizens to study the possibility of incorporating into Center Grove, not knowing whether or not in the end we would be able to gain your approval, and recognizing your authority in this process, we would like to ask this council to adopt and draft an ordinance, as stated here, that would simply state that should the citizens of Center Grove choose to incorporate into this town of Center Grove, that you would allow us to do so and allow us to incorporate right up to your boundaries and not enforce the 3 mile buffer zone that's allowed by the Indiana Code.
Sean, based on the fact that we are involved in litigation over one of the various issues, do you want to speak to that, or can?
Well, I don't want to talk about active litigation at public meetings, but you might do something that might be adverse to your position in your lawsuit with Barbersville, and I think that it is the prudent course to not commit to anything yet until you've completed your merger study and you see what is best, whether we should merge or whether they should incorporate their own town, and give them permission to do that.
And while I agree with that, the reorganization is not looking at incorporation at all. They're only looking at the reorganization of Greenwood and White River Township. So
and the
outcome of those meetings will not determine whether incorporation for Center Grove is better than reorganization.
And the reason for that is we are paying for the study.
I believe that half of the study is being funded by the citizens of White River Township.
I agree, but we are putting money into that pot.
Well, we don't have jurisdiction to incorporate a new town.
Right.
Correct.
You don't, but you have the authority at the end of the process to effectively stop incorporation for the citizens, even if that's what they want to do.
I think you've illustrated that point. I think maybe you have the cart before the horse. You can set on your own flow chart that this process will be at the end. I don't think we have the proper information until after the merger committee has done their work, until you guys do your work. What is the best scenario for the unincorporated area of White River Township?
I will say that 5 years ago, I went to some prominent members of the White River Township area and told them that they should look at this. And the fact that they didn't progress to the point where you are at this point means that the desire apparently was not there. And, you know, we're in the middle of a study. And until that study is done, I'm not going to commit either way. We've got to see what the study says, what the citizens say. So I'm against giving you approval at this point. You've got to figure out what, you know, the study of the merger does.
Do all the other members of the committee feel the same way as well?
Let's clarify what. From day one, there has been some lack of understanding. I won't say it's been miscommunication, but lack of understanding. The charge to that committee has never been by law or by the state statutes to look at incorporation. It doesn't allow us to do that. So the fact that it seems logical that we should is not allowed, correct, Sean?
Correct.
So we didn't have the option of saying new car, used car, or getting dad's car. We could only look at used car. We couldn't look at dad's car as an option to simplify it. So that has not been an effort by this council or the White River Township Board to hide anything. That's just the fact, the reality. It is not something we're to consider. The voters certainly have the opportunity to consider it when it comes up for a vote. And if you're working on that and making those presentations and those decisions, there's nothing this board or this council or anyone can do to stop you or anyone else from saying, here's an option that the public should consider, but the public will be asked to vote on the facts of the merger, not incorporation. So it's a strategy that you have to determine whether or not you and the people who are looking at incorporation want to develop as part of your future actions towards a merger study. All we'll be all voting on is whether or not it makes sense as it relates to a merger, not whether or not it makes sense for you to incorporate. So the misinformation that I feel has been out there from day one, I don't know if it's intentional just to misdirect people or if it's just accidental. But the fact is, we cannot look at incorporation as an alternative. Only you can.
I agree, and it says so right in the code.
Right.
It is a citizens' movement. It must be initiated and driven by the citizens.
Right. So I mean,
I'm aware of what.
So you know, you're asking us to say something we can't say until we've got facts to make facts decision on the facts that we have, and then the voters will make the decision based upon the facts they have as to whether or not the merger is appropriate. That has nothing to do with the incorporation idea.
But this council has essentially everything to do with the incorporation, because if you deny, if you enforce your buffer zone, the 3-mile buffer zone that's allowed by code at the end of our efforts, you will effectively kill any opportunities that the citizens have to incorporate.
But no decision has been made, so we can't make a decision prior to getting facts. I mean, I think we will be making a decision, and that decision was whether or not we're going to go forward and send it for a vote. That's our decision, correct, Sean?
Yes.
And if we send it for a vote, then the opportunity will be there for individuals to respond to that vote in whatever period of time that takes place.